views and opinions. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Lord, praise the Lord. We thank you, praise God, for being in his house one more time. Let us all just say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Glorify your name, God. You're so worthy to be praised. We thank you, praise God, for all of you that are here today, those that may be listening out in the world today. We just give God the glory for you. We're asking that you continue to be in prayer for us. I just pray and give God the glory for everything that he has done. He's been a mighty, mighty God. I thank him that I'll be able to go back to the Boys and Girls Club tomorrow. I'm looking forward to it after my surgery. So I thank God. I miss my babies over there. I give God the glory for the opportunity and for the healing, his healing power that he's doing for me. I just thank him for that. Today, Elaine will not be here with us today. He had a prior engagement, he and his wife, Arena. So I'll be handling the devotion. And Tatiana will be leading us in praise and worship, and then we'll go on into the Word of God. So we just thank God for all that he's doing for us today. Father God, as we come to you right now, we lift this service up to you. We cancel every assignment of the enemy. We plead the blood of Jesus over every individual that's listening to us today, Father God. We pray that you get the glory and the honor and all the praise out of every situation, the word, the devotion, the music, out of everything, Lord God. We pray in the name of Jesus that you, Lord God, are the one that we're here, Lord God, to lift up. Keep our eyes and our minds and our focus on you, God. And Lord, we give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 I was praying and seeking God's face for what he wanted me to minister on today, I also prayed over the devotion. We're getting our song together, so just be patient with us. Praying over the devotion that the Lord wanted me to share. And I found one that matches along with the sermon that I'll be ministering today, by Rick Warren, and I would like to do this devotion. And the title of it is Stay Focused on God's Plan for Your Life. As I was getting ready for the message today, the Lord just kept bringing it to my heart and my mind to tell his people to keep their eyes stayed on him, to stay focused, on him. And so when I found this, it just matched everything that the Lord wanted me to share with you today. And it says here, anyone who lets himself be distracted from the work I planned for him is not fit for the kingdom of God. This is in Luke chapter 9, verse 62 out of the Living Bible. It says, I have met thousands of why? They're too busy. They've got their own agenda going. They've got their plans and dreams and ambitions, and they don't have any time. In the midst of their busyness, they try to carve out a little silver from the pie of life and say, I'll give this to God. But it doesn't work that way. If you're serious about being used by God, you have to say, Lord, what do I need to let go of? What do I need to cut out? What barriers are holding me back and keeping me from running the race that you have for me? Lots of different barriers will hold you back from God's plan for your life. One of the biggest categories is distractions. Jesus said in Luke 9:62, anyone who lets himself be distracted from the work I planned for him is not fit for the kingdom of God. Here are a few of the many things that could distract you from your life's mission. The expectations of other people. You've got to decide who you're going to please first in life. You can only have one number one. Hobbies. There's nothing wrong with these things. But if they distract you from the most important things, then you need to let go of them. Your past. Maybe you refuse to let go of your past, whether it's guilt or resentment or grief. But if you're stuck in the past, you can't get on with the present. And you certainly can't get on with God's future for you. Your past is past. It's over. You need to let it go. What do you need to let go of? The Bible says in 1 Corinthians. What does that mean? It means this. A lot of things aren't necessarily wrong. They're just not necessary. Life often means choosing either, am I going to do something good or am I going to do what's best? If the devil can't make you bad, he'll make you busy. He'll get you so busy that you don't have time for the important stuff. Time alone with God, ministry, and mission. You need to simplify your life and eliminate distractions so God can use you. Don't try to do it all. Do what matters most. Praise God. I thank God for that devotion because that is so true. We need to, as God said to me earlier, stay focused on Him. And what he wants, praise God. And what he wants us to do, we need to stay focused. We thank God. The enemy is alive today, but we give God the glory. We thank God for Wes. He's doing his best. He always does. He sits back there and put things together in ways that I don't know how he does it, but he does a great job. So we thank him for that. I wanted to share something with you before we get into praise. West Main Church of the Nazarene, in conjunction with the Community Harvest Food Bank, has been blessed. We will have a program here at the church starting on November the 4th, which is a Wednesday, from 10:30 to 1 o'clock. Each day, we'll be giving out 10 food vouchers to the public, to the community, those who have a need. How this program is going to work. If you come in with a need on Wednesday, which we'll have a secretary here to write down information, we're not asking you for a lot. It's just your name and what we need to turn into the food bank. We will give you a voucher. If you have a need the following month, in order for you to be assisted, you will need to go through our finance workshop. We will be teaching and helping people with developing a budget, working on their financial situation, helping you in whatever way possible so that you can live a prosperous life. We will be doing this one workshop per month, starting in November until April. And the workshops are free. You just need to contact us at the church, or you can contact me personally. I will be putting information on Facebook. You can inbox me. Pastor Sandra White is under Sandra White on Facebook, because we will have to limit how many people will come to the workshops due to social distancing. We will set up a Zoom. In the future, we'll probably do that in December. So those that can't come in November, you can also participate in the workshop via Zoom. But it's best to be here. That way you can ask questions. We can help you personally with your budget and give you the information that you need. We thank God for Carl Keel, who has a degree in finance, and also Cody from out at Grace Point, who has a degree in finance, along with his father. They are financial managers. So we have people that are professional that will be here to help you. We want to help you, not just give you a handout of food and then the next month you're in need again. We want to help you to get stable and get on your feet. If you have issues with employment, you need to get resumes done, or you need to talk to someone about removing barriers to your employment, we will be here to help you get that done. It will only be an hour. Each workshop will run about an hour, but you do need to RSVP in order to participate. The voucher handout for the first 10 people, and it has to be on the first come, first serve basis, will be on November the 4th, which is a Wednesday, starting at 10:30. And then the workshops we will let you know that day, but we will also be announcing, I got to get with Cody and Carl and get their schedule. It will be in November. I'll find out the best day and time for them. And we'll have to limit the workshops to between 25 and 30 people so that we can keep the social distancing. The Community Harvest Food Bank has gifted us with the finances necessary to make this program work. And I thank God for what they have done. And I thank God for the people here at West Main that continue to pray. We are a small group, Gideon's Army, but we're doing what we can to help our community to be as strong as they can be. And we give God the glory for all that He's doing. And at this time, I will turn our service over to Tatiana and Deb for our praise and worship. God bless you.
Because of who you are, I give you praise. Gotta be where you are. wanna be where you are. Gotta be where you are. Wanna be where
hearts, Lord, and we ask you for all the glory, honor, and the praise. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Bless the Lord. Thank you. Praise God. Praise God. I do want to add to the announcement that I made about the vouchers that we'll be giving out. We're giving out 10 vouchers a week on Wednesdays, and we're going to plan to go through April. So there's plenty of opportunity to help as many people as we possibly can. So I just thank God for blessing this church to be able to bless others. Father, as I decrease, you increase within me. Lord, bring forth in my heart and in my mind the word that you have given me to share with your people today. Help me, God, to allow the Spirit to have preeminence in my life every day and to give your message in accordance to what you have given us. And we thank you and we praise you. We ask all this in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen. I want to give also, I was remiss to say, it's a praise report. One of our sister churches and their youth were back with us last Sunday. You heard the band that was here, the praise team, and they were outstanding youth of Grace Point Church of the Nazarene. And they not only helped us in praise and worship, but they completed the painting of our gutter area around our church, and then they went over to many nations. Some were here and some was at Many Nations Church helping, showing our youth how to do something for the Lord. And we had a blessed time, and I just thank God each and every time that they come to our church, what they do for us. And I thank and praise God for those that are out there that are willing to help this church. I told our congregation earlier today, God told me to preach the gospel, to give his message to his people so that they can be drawn into the kingdom, and he would take care of his house. And he's been doing just that, taking care of his house. As long as we obey what the Spirit is saying, God is going to take care of what is his. And I give God the glory, the honor, and all the praise for that. The message that God has given me today, as I have spoken earlier, is to stay focused. We're in a time in our lives where we need to stay focused on the Lord. Turn with me in your Bibles to Colossians chapter 3, verse 2. And when you find it, please stand for the reading of God's word. Colossians chapter 3, verse 2. There's a lot to be said in this scripture. Colossians chapter 3, verse 2. God has given me two scriptures to give to you today. This is the first. Colossians chapter 3, verse 2. Hallelujah. And it says, set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. Set your minds on things that are above and not on things that are on earth. And then the second scripture is Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. And it says, finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, is there anything worthy of praise? Think about these things. May God add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, and the doing of his word. You may be seated. Stay focused. What are the things that are above? The things that are above are the commandments of the Father. If we do these things, we will be able to endure anything that comes our way. Stay focused. You might say, well, I'm doing everything in my power to stay focused. I love the Lord and I'm trying to live my life according to what he wants, and I'm doing everything that I can, but there's so much going on. There's so much confusion. There's so much discontent. There's so many issues. There's so many problems. Every time I turn around, there's something that's happening in my life, and I'm just always involved in something, or people trying to get me involved, or there's things that are happening around me. It's difficult to stay focused. And you know what? You're right if you're doing it within yourself, within your flesh, within your own mind. It is difficult to stay focused. You'll find yourself becoming anxious. You'll find yourself being wrapped up in the cares of this world. And it's been said over and over again, the word of God says, you're in this world, but you're not of the world. So how do you stay separated? How do you stay focused? The way to do it is to keep that relationship with the Holy Spirit first and foremost in your heart and in your mind. Because, see, the Holy Spirit is not going to tell you anything other than what the Father wants you to know. The Holy Spirit is not going to lead you or direct you anywhere that Jesus Christ himself has warned you to go. The Holy Spirit will direct your life. The Holy Spirit will comfort your mind. The Holy Spirit will bring peace, will bring joy in your heart. It will help you to increase your discernment. The Holy Spirit, if you keep that intimate relationship with him, will tell you every single day what you're about to face and how you can overcome those things that you are about to face if we stay focused and allow the Holy Spirit to do the work that he wants to do in each and every one of our lives. I read Philippians 4:8 because I want you to think about staying focused on the things that we discussed in Philippians 4:8. Well, I want you to think about those things, whatever is true. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. What is the truth? What is true? Jesus Christ. He is the way, the truth, and the life. So if you continue to focus, allow the Holy Spirit to direct you and think on those things that are true, you're going to keep your mind on Jesus Christ. You're going to keep your mind on the characteristics that he has shown you throughout his life on how to live and how to handle negative situations and how to make it through this life. Whatever is true, think on that thing that's true. And the truth is Jesus Christ. Whatever is honorable. When you think about the definition of man's life, honorable is of high rank, dignity, or distinction, noble, distinguished, worthy of honor and high respect. As a child of God, people need to see us with dignity, with nobility. Not saying to put your nose up above nobody else, but to show yourself that I am a child of God. I have characteristics in me that I need to live in accordance to. I come from a noble background. I am the child of a king. I know that I have to live my life as a child of the king. And a child of the king don't backbite. A child of the king don't be out here disgracing his nobility or her nobility. A child of the king will live in accordance to the lifestyle that they're supposed to live. We will show love. We will show understanding. We will have wisdom. We will be wise in everything that we do. We will speak in accordance to what a noble child should speak. We will not have profanity coming out of our mouths, but we will be noble. We will be distinguished. We will show love in spite of, and we will show wisdom in everything that we do. We spend a lot of time on the outward appearance because we want people, when they see us, they want us to be seen with our nice clothes on, our hair done, and driving a nice car or whatever, and looking nice so that people can say, oh, look at them, they are this or they are that. But it's not the outward appearance that's going to get you into heaven. It's what's in your heart that's going to get you to heaven. And how you show people your love, that they are loved, is by the condition of your heart. The condition of your heart must be holy. The content of your character must reflect the nobility that you come from as a child of God. We can't always get wrapped up in everything that's around us. I was over in England, and I brought this up once before, and I'll do it again. I was looking at, when I went over to the palaces that where the queen was and the changing of the guard and all the things that was going on there, they did things in accordance to the nobility that was already established. They did everything in accordance to what they were supposed to do so that they would not disrespect the queen. We as children of God should not disrespect our king. We should not allow things to come out of our mouths or attitudes to come out and things to be around us that's not respecting the King of all kings and the Lord of all lords. The Holy Spirit will help us to stay focused, will help us to be the noble people and have the character that we need to have in our lives. If we allow him to do the work he is called to do, Jesus left him here for us to lead us, to guide us, to watch over us, to protect us, to show us the way. We spent a lot of time talking about the Father and a lot of people disrespecting the Son, but a lot of people don't even recognize the voice and the ways of the Holy Spirit. They don't even recognize that he's here. He's here. He's our Lord and Savior in here with us. He is the Holy Spirit. He is the one that's here, that's been sent by Jesus Christ to be here, to be our comforter. A comforter is one that will make sure the peace of God that transcends all understanding will guard your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus. Use the Holy Spirit. He wants us to have a relationship with him. Amen. He wants it. He desires it. We are the ones that have not taken advantage of the gift that has been set here for us, the Holy Spirit. The next thing is whatever is just, based on behaving according to what is morally right and fair. Christians must be just in everything that we do because we serve a just God. We have been freed by a just God, and we need to be just in everything that we say, in everything that we do. We cannot be of the world. We cannot be like the world. We have to be separated from the world to show the world a different way to go, to show the world a different way to live, to show the world that they can survive without backbiting and lying and cheating and shooting and doing all the things that's going on in the world today. There's a different way to make it. And we need to be the ones to show the world how to live. The Holy Spirit will speak to our hearts and give us the wisdom of what to say and when to say it. The Holy Spirit will direct our path so that we can do what the Father wants us to do, to live a just life. Whatever is pure, free of any contamination. In the world today, if you listen to the news and listen to all the things that people are saying, the world is being contaminated by a lot of anger and hate and lies and fear and destruction. What does that mean? Satan is running rampant in the world, because he is the author of all of that. He came to steal, to kill, and destroy. He will steal your dignity. He will steal the wisdom that the Holy Spirit is trying to give you. He will steal every good thing from you. He will kill your relationship with your brothers and your sisters. He will destroy it. Because that's what he came to do. He's on his job and he's doing his job. Brothers and sisters in Christ, now it's time for us to do our job. And that's to stand up in the power and the authority that's been given us by the freedom that we receive through. through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. The same Spirit that raised him from the dead lives in us. And that same Spirit will direct us and guide us in the right way to go, so that we will not be contaminated by the things of this world. That we will be able to pull others out of the muck and the mire and help to wipe them off and help them to get their lives together so that they can be viable Christians in this world today. But if we continue to follow after the patterns of this world, we can't do what God wants us to do because we're not focused on the right things. We're not focused on what God would have us to do. We're focused on the world and not focused on the Spirit. We must stay focused on the right things to do and live according to the Word of God and not according to the lies of man and the deceitfulness of the enemy. Whatever is commendable, deserving praise. Don't you know that it feels good when God comes, steps in and does something powerful or does something wonderful in our lives that we can praise? And if we share our testimony, too many of us, God is blessed in so many ways, but we hold our testimonies close to ourselves and we don't want to share. God wants us to share with others what he's brought us out of, so that we can testify of his goodness. We can praise his holy name so others can see what God has done and want to have a relationship with the Father just like we do, because they see the burdens being lifted off of our shoulders. They want to be able to praise God just like we do. But they can't do it if we never share what God has brought us out of. Amen. If we keep our testimonies close to our bosom, it's not helping anybody. Now, I didn't say testifying. I said testifying of the goodness of God. Share what God has done for you. Let the world know how good our God is. That he's not forsaken us. He's not left us. He's always with us. Always have a testimony to share, because you don't know where a person is and how your words might help to lift them up from the dirt. Help somebody through the word of your mouth. Praise God for what he has done for you. Hallelujah. If there's any excellence, an outstanding feature or quality, each and every one of us as children of God should have something about us that's outstanding. I'm going to say this, and I'm not just saying it because I know this individual, but there's an individual in this city I've watched over the years. Not just one, but this one particular one stands out. I've watched him over the years, how God has used him in an awesome way. How he exudes the love of Jesus Christ. How he's always out to help somebody. How he's always trying to do his best. How he shows integrity in his life. How he shows the love of Jesus Christ, not only by his works, but by the deeds that he does. That individual is the CEO of the Boys and Girls Club, Joe Jordan. This man has shown the love of Jesus Christ to so many. He has helped people. If you have a need and you contact him, if he can help you, he can help you. He will do it. He's showing the love of Jesus Christ to his community. I can't tell you what his relationship with the Father is. I can only tell you what I see in his life. So evidently there must be a relationship there, or he couldn't do the things that he does. There's so many out there that I could call by name, but that one stands out because I know how he's impacted my life and the lives of my family. and the lives of those that are around him through the Boys and Girls Club. And all I can tell you is, if everybody had an ounce of what he showed, we could change this city in so many ways. The love of Jesus. If we would just show that for our fellow brothers and sisters, this world would change in such a way. Lord, we keep saying, thy kingdom come. God wants his kingdom to come down here. Are we representing the kingdom on earth? We pray that thy kingdom come, thy will be done. What is his will? To love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your mind, and all your soul. And love your neighbor as you love yourself. Is that happening on earth? That's what was represented in the kingdom. Is it being represented on earth? Thy kingdom come and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We need to really think about that. That's a personal thing that you need to think about. Am I doing my part so that thy kingdom will come and God's will be done in my life and in the lives of those that I affect? If there's anything worthy of praise, to express approval or admiration, to commend, what's worthy of praise? God the Father is worthy of praise. Jesus Christ is worthy of praise. The Holy Spirit is worthy of praise, because we wouldn't be where we are today if it wasn't for God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. They're all one together, worthy of praise. Isn't it awesome to be called a child of God? We need to praise our fathers. We need to praise the Father. God the Father is who we need to be praising, lifting him up. As I said, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. The three distinct individuals, yet they are one. 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 There's no division. As a people, as children of God, we need to be one together in spirit without any division. We need to be one together. And if we stood as one, we would stand. Divided, we're going to fall. What is the devil trying to do? He's trying to divide the church. He's trying to divide God's children. He's trying to get us off focus so we won't remember who we are and what we've been called to do. We are supposed to be united in one body as one, not divided. Divided, we will fall. But united, in focus, in tune with the Holy Spirit, living according to what we are, kings of kings and queens and the Lord of lords and our host, we need to live our lives in a way that God will be pleased with us. My word to you today is to stay focused. Stay focused on the right things. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Praise God. God bless you. Before we have Tatiana come back with praise and worship, I was just told that we have two birthdays. Who are they?
Wes and Shirley.
Okay, Wes and Shirley for this month. Wes and Shirley, let's all sing happy birthday to them.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Wes and Shirley. Happy birthday to you.
It's a blessing to see another birthday. And we thank and praise God for that. Tatiana.
Living now. realize, am I living it? Do I live in it? So astounding. Love is an ocean, you can drown me. The sweet embrace, the lovely taste, I taste and see. I'm under grace, the place to be. It means I'll never need an umbrella. I'm cool in the cold, in the hot weather. Whether or never I ever understand, I'm a man in the hands of great plans. I stand with faith and a life I never known to touch. And still I stop my clutch, but I'm like, what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? Live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'ma live it, I'ma live it to death. So what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? And live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'ma live it, I'ma live it to death. Yeah.
Oh, nation, O King of my heart. Nothing else satisfies, only you, Lord. You are my best thought by day or by night. Waking or sleeping, your presence, my light.
Chains are gone, I've been set free. my hope secures. He will my share and portion me as long as life endures. My chains are gone.
Happy holidays from all of us at Parkview Health.
On the first day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me a hospital in my community. On the second day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me two acts of love and a hospital in my community. On the third day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me three true friends, two acts of love and a hospital in my community.
True friends, two acts of love, and a hospital in my community. teammates swinging, selling trainers, treating sisters and swing. Five thanks with wings. Four healing cures, three true friends, two acts of love, and a hospital in my community. On the 12th day of Christmas, my parking gave to me 12 drummers drumming, 11 abbey sniping, 10 Texas sweeping, 9 doctors dancing, 8 teammates swinging, 7 trainers treating, 6 nurses swinging, 5 knights with wings. 4 healing cures, 3 true friends, 2 acts of love, and a hospital in my community.
www.burnsville.org/traffic.
Everything I need you are.
Before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Let every heart say, Amen.
Let's start.